Hello, and welcome to Best Paper Watch. After spring, summer, autumn, and winter, conference is definitely one of my favourite seasons. And as part of this year's conference season, we here at FDG TV have decided to help you out not just by identifying some of the most interesting guests and speakers at the conference, but also by featuring some of those best papers that you've seen hiding away in that programme. But have you ever wondered where the conference organisers find these best papers? Where do they get them from? Well, for this year, we've spent all of our FDG TV budget sending me to the south coast of England to find those spots in the wilderness, along the coastlines, in the forests, among the countryside, and identifying exactly where we can find those amazing best papers in their natural habitat. And I hope you'll join me every day this week as we track down some of the finest papers to come out of this conference season. Now, when it comes to tracking down best papers, many of them are actually quite hard to find. Lots of them like secluded areas, out of the way, they're very shy, and that's one of the reasons why we only manage to come together once a year somewhere like FDG to see the ones that have been collected over the last 12 months. That said, this week we are going to track down some of them in places like this woodland behind me. In actual fact, we had some footage sent over earlier of a best paper that was spotted in this area that we're hopefully going to get a glimpse of today. Now that paper that you just saw a brief glimpse of there, I believe that was actually a grounded theory of accessible game development. Now, in this paper, the authors look at the issue of game accessibility, which, as we all know, is very important and growing in importance as other game developers and publishers around the world get interested in it. But one of the things that the authors do in this paper that really sets it apart is they've conducted a series of interviews with game developers during the COVID lockdown and asked them questions like, what do they think accessibility is? What are their views about it? What are the things that are stopping them from getting involved in accessibility or sort of slowing down the development of their studios? And in doing so, they've identified a host of interesting reasons why accessibility is hard to come by. For example, they found that many people find that they're not sure who to talk to at their development studio about it. Sometimes there's not enough resources, whether that's time or money. Or in some cases, being concerned that accessibility clashes with the game's design in some way. Now, this sort of wide-ranging interview spans so many different people and so many different views, and that's why this paper is so important, because it gets us that perspective on this topic that we don't normally get. So make sure you have a look and read through some of the excellent quotes that have been picked out by the authors too, and of course their overall findings at the end. Now, of course, what's really important when we're tracking down best papers like this is that we don't disturb the natural habitats or these papers in their day-to-day lives. And that's why today I've got an artist's rendition of our next best paper, which is dealing with adversarial player strategies in the neural network game Ink through ensemble learning. So in this paper, the authors are talking about a game called Ink, in which players have to communicate a word to one another by drawing it on some digital paper, while a neural network tries to guess the code word by looking at what they've drawn. And what they noticed was that the humans were using some interesting tricks to bypass the neural network. For example, they were splitting their word up into multiple words and drawing several separate images. They were drawing an image and then scribbling on top so the neural network couldn't tell what was going on. And this paper details how they identified these exploits and then adapted the neural network to solve them using an ensemble technique that mixes together several different networks that are capable of tackling these different exploits. And they show that on their own, you can target a particular exploit and train the network to solve that particular one, but then it'll be bad against the other exploits, it'll be bad against the general task of playing the game. But if you build this system that sort of combines all of these exploits in different spaces and different parts of the neural network, what you end up with is something that's more than the sum of its parts. It's able to tackle all of these exploits while still playing the game effectively. Neural networks are becoming a bigger part of game design, and so looking at how they can be exploited and how we can sort of fight back against that by designing our AIs to be better is a very interesting and worthy topic. I'm very glad we didn't disturb it today in its nest, though. That's all we've got time for this first episode of FDG TV's Best Paper Watch. I hope you'll join me tomorrow, where we'll be finding more best papers, and indeed every day throughout this week, as we travel to the coast, up hills, and even in our own back garden, tracking down some of the best possible papers you could find at this year's FDG. I hope you'll join me. In the meantime, if you want to see when these papers are being presented, don't forget to go to the official website that's shown along here right now, and I'll see you back here same time tomorrow. Bye.